Dan has good mentality when he's not.
See that beautiful man on the right there. That is Anthony Slocks Dittres.
Yeah, dude. Ant is really one of my favorite players to watch growing up. I'm Connecticut. He's Connecticut, but I also consider myself pretty bi-regional. He's bi-regional. He's a cool guy, too. And I love that hair. It's so cool.
Oh, are these guys not even hand warming?
Yeah, they're not. So the overlay's not accurate, but Slocks is the fox, sort of the Sly Fox, with the amazing hair on the right. I'm not sure the shape.
Yeah, I can't say I quite like that yet, but I'm mostly attacking. Like, oh, I wonder who that is. But Slocks started off with a very commanding slap-a-roo.
Yeah.
With his, fox play, man.
For sure. Tech chase. Oh, nice. Catches the tech and lets. Okay. I think he was trying to do some reads, but again, someone like this. Oh, great needle down smash. Okay, and hold leg. I like that.
Okay, I was wondering, because this is the beautiful thing about Melee. There's always multiple correct options that we can do.
Yeah.
When he got those needles, he forced Slocks to recover. Oh my god, is he dead?
That low percent in order to just deal with, you know, eating the bear. At least he's not dead. Because that wasn't bad instinct. It's just, you got to be careful about percent when you're dealing with very, players who have a lot of good game sense. Slocks is one of them.
Okay, I like that forward tilt. It actually forces a hard knockdown. Tries to get the shine, not quite able.
So close. Yeah, so the Sheik was using these kind of double jumps to ledge. It's better to use a Sammy stall or use the first part of up to while you're refreshing ledge so you won't get the shine by the box.
There we go. We have an update on the overlay. The Sheik is Fable.
Okay. The player cams, the names may be switched.
Yeah, they
that's
are
good
swapped.
For now. There we go.
Just like that, instant transmission.
Oh! Yeah, I like this movement, though, from Fable. He's doing some very cool, like, niche approaches.
Okay. Looks like Slocks is accidentally goes out to take the labor.
Yeah.
That's the homie.
Yeah, really.
Look at he's taking his sweet time. He realizes that Fable doesn't really know how to approach on him, so just run forward, double jump back, and say, holy, holding the space.
Slocks didn't go for an aerial there. He just baited out the double jump, and then knew the edge guard was going to be much easier. And that's what you got to do when you get to like this level. Don't overextend your character. Just keep it good to make them kind of bury themselves.
What I actually really love about that last edge guard that Slocks could do is that he decided to do the initial get up early, do the bump 10%, right? And then after that, instead of going for a down smash, a lot of people do, he goes for the back air because he knows, hey, this would be a little bit harder for you to off attack, and I don't like it with.
Yeah. And in general, again, it's all about like minimizing what your opponent can do, minimizing their options, and keeping yourself at a point where you don't have to overreach.
Look at that, they've waking up, getting stuff good, fighting off that tech chase.
But these hits.
Grab that ledge. He lands on stage, but no punish for talk. Okay, yeah, we out. Okay. Careful, man. He hasn't talked. Doesn't matter.
He's fine.
That was, you know, that definitely a misinput or biggest disrespect of all time. One of the two. But
sure,
I'm going with the former.
Yeah, definitely. I don't really see how that could have disrespected him. I'd say the maybe he was trying to do like take a place down smash. He's like really mashing that.
Yeah,
so
just like
Dreamland. It's a good counter pick, but if Slocks is, you know, moving and running around, that makes it really hard for Fable to catch up.
Yeah, and I like that. The very first thing Slocks does off of that tech chase situation is go for the tech play shine. He says, let me test your reaction. If you're not about it, I'm getting this 3 damage and reverse it. What was a positive situation for you, now it's a positive situation for me.
Oh my god, that edge gets up there to bear. These up airs keeping the juggle alive.
This man's making me yodel more than like
I don't know
some El Dorado. Yeah, he was very far away.
Well, it's a tough angle to get where you just drop down and grab the ledge. I see what he's going for. Nice, gets that tech. Forward throw.
Nice.
Oh, no. Okay.
He's going to live. But
that was just missed time.
And it is a lot of things, right? So, start of flames, frame 20. We all know this by now, right? The Firefox flames come out on frame 20. Go down there any more than that, they're altering every other frame is the fire hitbox, right? So you got burned by the flames. But the moment he got that laser, the needle, all he had to do was jump, turn around needle, grab ledge, just back air.
Yeah,
he
used the invincibility, sure. I mean, his needle turnarounds, I haven't really been seeing them. Maybe they're not as good as some of his other techs.
Yeah, maybe. That could be the thing.
Yeah, we saw the unfortunate SD though coming in from Fable in that last dock. So it's tough when you're at such a big deficit, especially when Slocks is just beating up on you in neutral.
It's also a lot easier to say, hey, you should have done this, because like, I'm not the one playing right now.
For sure. Look, my fingers are not on a controller. Like, I have nothing on that. I don't play shoot.
All right, yep. Look at how quick he's able to move.
I love these rinse and repeats from Slots. Exactly.
Oh, you're going for down smash. I'm so surprised because at that percent, you know, I thought you were up smash something else. But give Fable another chance here. Try to go high.
That was smart from Slots. He did a laser turnaround. They wanted to face the other way. So that way it made his wave dash back to what's easier. This is great movement coming from Slots. Slots going to be definitely a chance to win the whole tournament. He's going to be fighting for it.
Yeah, he's definitely one of the top contenders. Unfortunately for Fable, we saw what happens a lot sometimes is that when Sheik and whoever she's facing are kind of right on top of each other, sometimes you see the forward tilt go right over their head.
Yeah.
It's, like, it's really annoying. But,
weird. That's another one where Fable's throwing out these down tilts knowing that Sox can't like get the sweet spot to ledge on the side. Or at least he's gambling on it. He got it to work, and that was great.
That is such a successful conversion. That's going to be a 2-0 Gomez Locks over Fable. Fable put in a valiant fight. Going to have to do his best to lose his bracket. But, you know, he didn't seem to be too shabby at all. You know, he had his stuff.
No.
He had
no, he did.
Slocks just kind of really just domineered. And even with that last punish we saw him got, right? You know,
yeah.
Some people saw him got, saw him get. He did the whole.
He had some DI mix-ups in there.
Yeah.
I mean,
up to the back air.
To the up air. That's like some Captain Falcon stuff. Oh, and Slocks.